Since the advent of disposable contact lenses, giant papillary conjunctivitis isn't as prevalent as it once was, but it's important to identify and treat appropriately when encountered in our offices. The number one reason we see GPC in our practice will be contact lens abuse. These patients will often present with complaints of uncomfortable lenses, excessive mucus discharge, and in some severe cases, visual fluctuations secondary to excessive movement of the lens with blinks, as can be seen here. These patients will oftentimes present with significant deposits on their lenses, as this is believed to be the inciting agent for the development of GPC. We are strong advocates of averting the upper eyelid on all patients, but most importantly, contact lens wearers. As can be seen here, a patient's developing early signs of GPC that would have gone unnoticed had the lid not been averted. Additionally, we're strong advocates for the use of fluorescein dye while viewing the eye with the cobalt blue light through a Raten filter. As you can see here, greater appreciation for tissue swelling is noted as the fluorescein demarks individual papillae on the tarsal plate. Now, the first step in treating patients with GPC is removing the inciting agent, which typically involves temporarily discontinuing contact lens wear. What we do in the office is also swab the superior tarsal plate to remove excessive mucus that may be present. Although the condition is relatively self-limiting, when contact lens wear is discontinued, we prefer to accelerate the resolution of this condition by prescribing a topical corticosteroid 4 times a day. For GPC, we feel that Lodamax gel works very well. Because of the vehicle that the medication is in, it maintains a consistent concentration throughout the bottle, so shaking the bottle isn't necessary for patients to do. After pharmaceutical intervention, resolution typically occurs relatively rapidly. As you can see in this patient, the initial presentation was relatively aggressive, but 1 week after discontinuing lens wear and beginning topical corticosteroid therapy provides substantial improvement in the appearance of the tarsal plate. Consider averting the upper eyelid on all patients, but most importantly, contact lens wearers, as this will demonstrate early changes in the tarsal plate. And when treatment is warranted, remove the inciting agent and begin corticosteroid therapy. And make sure to follow up with these patients to ensure appropriate resolution of the condition. In doing so, you'll ensure that those at risk of dropping out of lenses will continue wearing them successfully. Ultimately, this will improve patient outcomes, which is ultimately why we do what we do. We hope that this has been clinically insightful.